Hey guys, LeBlin here, and today's another BTD6 video. Today's gonna be the Two Towers Chimps achievement using the Ray of Doom and the Prince of Darkness. Sorry, that intro is just a little bit of a tongue twister for me. I've done it like 35 times trying to say those words correctly, like Two Towers achievement chimps. See, I did it wrong again. But either way, we're gonna go to logs here, we're gonna go to hard, and then we're gonna go to chimps. Now this one's really, really fun, not only because we get to use the Ray of Doom on chimps, which is just really cool, but it turns into like a little shooty game at the end, and we get to use the plasma accelerator to hit balloons with our own like targeting, which is just kind of fun. But I assure you it's gonna be very, very, very easy. You're not gonna have any problems at all. So whatever you guys came here for to watch the video, whether it's for Two Towers chimps, logs on chimps, or just to have this challenge of getting the Ray of Doom on chimps, you're gonna knock this out with no problems. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna drop a mage right here in this top, bottom, middle area, left area, the same place that I did for my Fire Lord Phoenix and my Archmage strategy. But this one we're gonna be using the Prince of Darkness because he's only like 25,900 and something for his fifth tier, which is gonna come in very good handy when this guy's 102,000. Plus this guy, since his recent buffs, is just, I wanna say overpowered. For such a cheap price, this guy wrecks those later rounds, the mid rounds. It's just awesome. Now the first upgrade we're going to buy is going to be a fireball for 325. Then we're going to save up 325 for intense magic. But before we get there, I have to give a big, big, big thank you to everyone, because right before I hit record on this video, I just hit 30,000 subscribers on YouTube. That is such an intense feeling to feel, to think that like back in July of 2019, I had maybe 75 or 100 subs or something like that. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to push this really hard. I'm going to put out a ton of videos. I'm going to try to grow this channel. And then just, what is that? 2 years later, a little less than 2 years later, we're at 30,000 subs. It is just such a cool feeling, and I can't thank you guys enough for helping me get this far. So thank you guys so much. Okay, now we're gonna grab intense magic for 325, and then we're gonna save up $1,080 for the Dartling, because we can't get the Wall of Fire just yet because it's a little random. I don't wanna deal with that. So we're gonna get Dartling first. So on round 12, what we're gonna do is we're gonna change targeting just real quick. You don't have to if you don't want to. It's just like one or two times out of 10, these yellows will get too far down the track and we'll lose a balloon here or there. I don't want any randomness, and to eliminate that, all we're going to do is we're going to change it to strong as soon as we see the yellows pop out. Nothing too crazy, nothing too fast. He's going to pop them all right here. This last one, change it back to first, and now you're good to go. And like I said, like 8-9 times out of 10, he'll just do it on his own on first, but why take the chance? We just spent some time getting here. Let's just keep on rolling through it, make sure everything works out simply. Now we're gonna save up 1080 for the Dartling, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna place him right in this spot here, because if we place him down here, he blocks off like this whole area. We don't want none of that. So we're gonna place him right here and then immediately lock him in place up there. I'm just letting you guys know before so you don't feel too rushed at this whole thing, but it's really not that bad. So we're just gonna place it right here, go right there. And then as you can see, I'm taking my time. I'm really slow at it. We're gonna go locked and lock it right there. And there we go. And the reason why we're getting him first is just to keep out the randomness. He can clean up anything that walks by him. Super simple stuff. Now we are safe to save up 970 for that Wall of Fire. Here we go on round 17 for that Wall of Fire. And now what I would like to do is I wanna get this guy upgraded a little bit. So to start upgrading him, we're gonna get focus firing, and then we're gonna get advanced targeting, because 24 is gonna come up pretty quickly. And I don't wanna put monkey sense on him just yet, cause it's kind of a waste of money, cause he's not gonna need it really, by the way. So we're gonna get advanced targeting here, and then we're gonna get laser shock for 970. And then we're gonna get faster barrel spin. Here we go with that laser shock. And now with the faster barrel spin for 1025, this thing's just gonna plow through everything. Super simple stuff. So with the 2-2 Dartling, we're pretty good to go, but our leads are gonna be kind of a problem. And so instead of saving up for like laser cannon that can't pop purples or the plasma accelerator and spend all that money, we're just gonna get this guy up first. We're gonna get monkey sense and then shimmer and then the undead necromancer popped army, because they just walk through everything, which is really, really convenient. So whatever this guy can't clean up, he's gonna just plow right through it for us. So let's grab Shimmer for, what was that, 18 or 1935. Now we're gonna save up 3,025 for the Necromancer Unpopped Army. In the meantime, you don't have to do anything. Don't change the targeting. Just leave him just as is. Here we go. So on round 36, we're gonna grab the Necromancer Unpopped Army. And now guys, and now, we're gonna literally save up $25,920. We will not upgrade this guy just yet. I wanna get this guy to fifth tier so he can pop everything, and then we'll upgrade this laser cannon because he can't pop the purples. I did wanna show you guys round 40 though, so you don't have to worry. I am not gonna change targeting. The little minion army, like if you just put the Dartling there himself, he can't handle it. But with the minion army, it's so simple. He's just gonna pop everything open and then he's just gonna clean it up with his little team underneath. Not a big deal at all. Look at that. easy stuff there. And we're gonna do the same thing until we get all the way up to 25,920. I think on round 50, we'll still have to beat those Moabs, but even then, don't have to do anything. I do wanna go through round 50 with you as well to show you that it is pretty easy, but it's not too bad. I mean, because the Moabs are so spaced that it's just like two separate round 40s, which we already beat, so it's not a big deal. So he's gonna pop those open. His little undead army is gonna pop the rest, because as you can see, this thing stays stacked with those 500s the whole time. And now we can grab Prince of Darkness. There we go, 25,920. And we got the big dog here. Things are gonna start being, I mean, I'm gonna say they start being easier, but I mean, really, what have we done so far? It's really like, not like it's difficult. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna get Laser Cannon for 4590, and then we're going to get Plasma Accelerator for a lot more. So I'm gonna grab Laser Cannon on round 54, and now we're just gonna save up 11,880 for that Plasma Accelerator. So right before round 60, we're gonna get the Plasma Accelerator, and we are going to put it actually right where it's at is perfect. Now what I'm looking for is it to be on this track here, because then the main little beam's there, but then we got it to walk through here and here and here and here and here, and it's just that simple. So even the BFB can't hang, and we're just gonna leave it like this. I'm literally about to get up from my computer, actually go get some more water, grab a snack, and I'm gonna jump back in on round 80. So 29, what's that? I can't even do math. 18 rounds from now. So every time there's a ZOMG, we do have to use our micro skills. And the reason why is just because he's just not strong enough to break open that. He can break open BFBs and fortified BFBs, but just the ZOMGs he just struggles with. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to follow it around. And as you can tell when you're hitting it because the little thing lasts for a while, you know, and then you're, oh, I'm back on it. There you go. And you can wiggle it around really fast. You can kind of just hold on top of it. It really doesn't matter. You don't have to have like expert first person shooter skills or nothing, or targeting skills, because the Moabs are so big and these are so not. So there we go, we beat that. Now we just lock him back in place over here right where he was, and we go back to it. And then, but then every time there's ZOMG, whether there's 1, 2, or 10, we just need to fight the ZOMGs. So 85 has, I think, 2 ZOMGs. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slow it down, come over here, turn him off lock to normal, and then just start attacking him. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just kind of hit both of them just so they both get that like a thing going on, you know, with the little, what do you even call that, damage per second stuff? But we're just gonna leave it on there, or damage over time. There we go. But we're gonna just keep eating this one up. We'll zap them a little bit. Really doesn't matter. Just kind of break those down to Moabs. Then we can go back to this guy. Because meanwhile, we still do have the awesome Prince of Darkness wrecking everything. So it's not like it has to be fast or efficient. We just gotta take them down eventually. And then after we get those back, we go back to here, locked just like so. And then the Prince of Darkness and the leftover remnants of our Ray of Doom as we're throwing it across the track pops everything else. So, like I said, only ZOMGs. That's the only thing he can't take down. DDTs, cool. Fortified BFBs, cool. Just not ZOMGs. Here we are again on 87. Now we got a ton of these guys rolling in here. I think there's three, right? But again, does not matter. Just pop them and get them. Is there three or four? I can't even count right now. This looks like a lot. Okay, there's three. No, that's definitely four. That is clearly four, right? Yeah, that's four. Okay, so let's pop that guy. Let's pop this guy. You can kind of pop the first ones if you want, but the Prince of Darkness seems to do all the work. But I mean, worst case scenario, look how fast you can move this thing. You can slow down and be like, no, I'm gonna get you down over here, or I'm gonna get you here. So you really don't have to worry about it. This is why it's fun for me. Like, this is more fun than like timing like ninja abilities or something like that. I'm gonna put this guy back over here, so just like right there in that spot we had him before. Yeah, it's definitely more fun for me to like do this and micro this ability than to use all the other stuff. But here we are in 88, and we do have some ZOMGs, so I'm actually gonna drop it back down to normal. But as you can see, I didn't start hitting him up here, and I'm not even hitting him now. Like, it's not that big of a deal. With this cool guy over here, he still has his graveyard going. We are more than good to go. So I think so far, let me think, it's round 80. Round 85, right? And then round 87 and round 88 are the ZOMGs. What's kind of cool too, though, is another little trick I guess I should have used myself, is like right now I'm not locked in place. I just have my mouse on it. So if you guys are on mobile, you guys can do the same thing. Just kind of tap it there and let it be. And then it's easier to pick it up, because when you're on impoppable and you have the right monkey knowledge, you have that really cool ability. You can hit one or two, whatever number it is, and then it pops it back into your control, which is really, really awesome. But for this, we'll just leave him right here and watch him take down the DDTs. I think it's more so the Prince of Darkness, but either way, together, they are amazing. So here we go with a ton of ZOMGs. So I'm gonna pick up my mouse or your finger if you're using the mobile, and you're just gonna just zap them all, guys. Zap them all, not a big deal. I mean, honestly, it's probably better, I would just say, to like, you know, signal out one guy, but I just like to go like this. I don't think it matters either way, but it's probably better just to focus on one, take him out and pop everything like that, you know? But we can pop this, and then we want to probably just focus on the ceramics just a little bit in case something gets crazy. Just clean up everything. You got an eraser in your hand. It's like your Microsoft Paint back in like 2001, and you got the cool eraser on the tip of your mouse. So you're just like, yeah, and you just get everything. Just look at these guys go. This is so easy. Okay, so 94 again, ZOMG. So I'm going to kind of disregard those bigger ones there, the BFBs and stuff. Let's try this one. Let's focus on one at a time. Now, see, that's not fun for me, guys. I like going... I'm just attacking everything. I think it's way more fun. All right. Because then it gets everybody and then everyone's involved. And we just have this big onslaught rush of things. But then it's cool because then they pop like near the range of Mr. Cool over here, which means that they're going to get more in the graveyard. And we're just going on about random tangents here. But it doesn't really matter. We got Eraser just killing everything. So cool. Okay, now that we got all those beat, let's go after the first one. So let's just make it a little easier on ourselves. So attack everything that's first. As you can see, it doesn't really even matter where you leave it because you got the Prince of Darkness. Okay, so 95. Let's just leave it and see if it works. Since I promised you that it's no ZOMGs or it's only ZOMGs, no DDTs or BFBs or Fortifieds or whatever. So we're just going to test it out. Let's see. So far, so good. Nothing. Okay. I like it. Yep. I was a little skeptic and I don't know why. I was just a little nervous, but I don't know why I should have been. Okay, so now what we're going to do is during this round, we are going to get 102,600. So just take down everything that you can in the meantime. It doesn't really matter. Just break down these guys, pop them, get that money. Then as soon as we get it, we're going to have the Ray of Doom. We'll lock him back in place and it's all so simple. So just get that money. Pop these things up. There we go. Just erase. And the reason why, we could just have left it up there if you wanted to and get the money, but I wanted to get Ray of Doom faster because it's more fun that way. And then all we're going to do is we're going to lock him in place up here like we did before, and then we're done. On 100, the bad will slip through. So we do have to attack the bad as well, but now we don't have to attack the ZOMG. So for 96, 97, 98, we're just going to leave this thing run and I will jump back on round 100. But I do hope I made that last part clear enough. We didn't have to attack everything like that because I promised you guys we only have to attack the ZOMGs. But what I was doing was, I don't even know if the math on that is correct. I was just trying to get the Ray of Doom faster so we could have gone back to doing nothing. But I imagine if you would have left it at the top and just focused on the ZOMGs, the same thing would have happened. You would have popped everything behind. But I was impatient, guys. I just wanted this Ray of Doom. I honestly can't believe the way he just eliminated 98 and 99. Look at this. This is ridiculous. Okay, let's unlock him now for this guy. And all you got to do is follow him around. Nothing crazy. He can't hang enough. I guess it's just not enough damage and the bad move's too slow, I guess. I don't really get it. But he can't do it, so we're gonna do it like this, and he's more than qualified to wreck this bad as long as he's popping him, of course. So we're just gonna keep following him around, nothing crazy. And then after what seems like a very long time, we're gonna pop this guy open, take out those DDTs. There we go, and then take out the ZOMGs. I mean, I guess technically you could just lock it back in place, but there's no point now. We're on round 100. You might as well finish it off, go out strong. Pop these ZOMGs. The pod's gonna help out. Pod's helping Rod, and we're just gonna knock through this thing. And we get a 0-2-0 Instamonkey for all of our efforts. Guys, I'm loving this. I love this strategy, and I love the Ray of Doom. I wish I could use them more, but since I mainly do chimp strategies, I never really get to use. So this was a lot of fun. But I really hope you guys like this. It was a lot of fun for me. I hope those last couple rounds weren't too difficult to understand, because I know there's a lot going on with that. But basically, the gist of it was, if you guys watch this first and then go back and do it, the gist of it was to make sure you attack every ZOMG because we can't really hang, then you can lock it back. On those last couple rounds before we got the Ray of Doom, I just wanted to make it a little safer and clean it up, but I've also done it to where I didn't do anything and I also just locked it back in place. So it's whatever you guys want to do. I think it's more fun to mess with that thing and play with the Plasma Accelerator. And are we really wrecking 102 right now? This is awesome. We can just keep going with this strategy because the Ray of Doom is really, really cool. So actually, let me know below, now that we have all this money left over, keep going, guys. How far can you take it? And let me know how far you do take it. But you guys are awesome. Thank you for 30,000 subscribers. Thank you for watching this video. Like if you liked it. Consider subscribing if you haven't already. And I will see you guys next time.